Bira.
How's it going?
Hey, cool to have you here. Yeah, so you do R&D for Victory?
I do, indeed, yeah.
Yeah, and you do a live playing, you do.
Thank you very much.
Very good sound. So what did you play here?
What I played here was, well, I'm currently running through the Victory VX Kraken amplifier using my Chapman guitar, and was just a combination of some reverb and delay, bit of fuzz, and I just like making big sounds with the Kraken amplifier.
Okay, so the Kraken is a little bit of high gain amp, is it?
Yep.
Yeah. It's based around, it's catering for those that like modern hard rock metal, progressive metal, but it can also do a lot of other stuff too.
Yeah. But what I think it's not really metal amplifier. It's just like vintage high gain for me.
Yeah. It's I mean gain one. It's basically two gain channels. The first one is more British voiced, and gain two is supposed to be more American high gain.
Yeah. So that was what we heard before.
Yeah.
Okay. So give us some example here.
Okay. This being gain one, which you can use. I use it for more of an ambient sort of channel.
So very good for with the compressor and the reverb and delay.
Yeah, I like ambient sounds, so I put a lot of that in there. But then if you wanted to go chuggy chug, you can just... And it
does that too.
Yeah, very good. So, I mean, we all know Martin Kidd is the man behind.
The man, the myth, the legend, yeah, Mr. Legend. Martin Kidd.
So we all love Cornford, of course.
Yep.
And I did many, many demos of the Victory amps here, and I said in every demo, Martin is the man for high gain. He's a good player, is he?
He's an amazing player.
Amazing player.
Yeah, totally. Yeah, so, very good.
Okay, so you did some development too?
Yes.
So with the Victory amps here?
Yeah, I came on board at the beginning of this year as sort of working on the R&D team. So basically I go to the factory, to the place with Martin, and we'll sit down and look at new amplifiers, and I'll kind of go, needs a little bit more mid-range. And he goes, okay, gets the soldering iron out, makes it, comes back, how's that? And I'll go, perfect.
That's a dream.
That's basically what happens, yeah. Well, with this particular amp, it was more in depth. My involvement was more in depth. I was asked, before I started working for Victory, to help them design a metal amp. So that's what that is. I took some of my favorite amplifiers, favorite modern high gain and vintage high gain tones, and we put it all together into that. So.
Okay, so it's good for high gain and good for drop tunings, but it's also good for vintage Stratocaster.
Yeah, which I will show you. Now, I mean, of course, using single coils on a high gain isn't always recommended, but you can most certainly get a beautiful low gain tone out of this guitar, out of this amplifier on gain one.
That's sweet.
Yeah, it's pretty spanky. It's good. It's quite a versatile amp.
Yeah, very good.
But they all are. All the Victory stuff is versatile.
Absolutely. So you do the Victory show here tonight, so all the fans are waiting outside. So what amps do you have here?
Okay, so we've got pretty much most things. We over behind me, we've got the Sheriff 22, which is the kind of the little plexi lunchbox head. It's based around that kind of classic plexi circuit. Really, really great. Barky amplifier. Then we've got the BD1, which is based around the Rob Chapman signature amplifier, the RD1, but this is basically a black version for those that don't want a bright red amplifier. But that's great. And then we've got the V30, which was Victory's flagship lunchbox head, that was the first one that was released of the lunchbox series and did very well. Then we've got the Kraken, and we've got the Earl, which is from the Hanwide series, which is a 50-watt two-channel amplifier, kind of everything you'd expect from a classic two-channel amplifier with a nice thick saturated gain and a spanky clean. And then we've got one of the newer V40 Deluxe, which is kind of based around a kind of Fender Deluxe kind of reverb, one voicing, and then you go to more of a classic Marshall on another voicing. But it's a single channel amplifier, so it's things that, you know, you could gun the master, drop the volume down and get a very beautiful clean, or you could crank the volume and drop the master and get more distortion, more saturation. It's a really, really nice amplifier for that, with built-in tremolo and reverb, which is stunning. And it's all tube-driven tremolo, proper spring reverb tank, so very, very cool. And then we have sat underneath, then next to it we have its predecessor, which is the V40, the Duchess, which is... It's got two voices, again, similar to a kind of Fender-ish clean and then some sort of vintage voice Marshall stuff again. But it's a smaller wattage, it's smaller lunchbox head. It has digital reverb, but it's a great, great amplifier. And the cool thing about both V40s are they're exceptionally good at taking pedals. So, you know, if you use a lot of pedals in your rig, they're a great platform for pedals, and they're a great platform for effects and all sorts of stuff like that. I know a lot of players are very satisfied with that. And then sat underneath the Duchess down there is the V10, which is our only combo, like our main 10-watt combo. It only came out as a combo, but it's got some pretty cool features. You can actually mix and blend the output valves, depending on what kind of sound that you want to go for. So yeah, there's all sorts of cool stuff. We got a different range of cabs as well, with different speakers in, Creambacks, V30s, vertical and horizontal 212s. So there's a lot to talk about.
Wow. Okay. So there's a lot to do here for tonight.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Totally.
So like I said before, the girls and Lamar are waiting outside.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Thank you for coming down from the UK for Victory here.
Thank you for having us.
Good luck for that evening here.
Thank you very much, man. Yeah. Pleasure to be here.